Okay, this is how you convert numbers between two different bases without going to base 10. We'll do it directly. And depending on what base you want to get to, you should have the times table on the side to help you, because if not, we will go crazy. Anyway, I will show you guys how to get to base 7 from different bases. And the first example is 11201 in base 3 to base 7. So this is an example how to go from a smaller base to a bigger base. I will show you guys another example to go from a bigger base to a smaller base. Right? And here is the times table in base 7. In fact, I have a video on this. If you haven't seen it, be sure you guys go check that out. Okay, here we are going to start by expand this, and we'll do it this way. Starting from the number from the left, right here we have 1, and then we multiply by 3, and then I add the next number, which is 1, and then we multiply by 3, and then we continue, we add 2, and then we put parentheses, and then we multiply by 3, and then we add 0, put parentheses, and then we multiply by 3, and then we are going to add the 1 right here. So this is how we can expand this number in base 3. How does this work? It's pretty much the same thing as usual. As you can see, let's take this one for example. How many times are you doing the 1 times 3? So you have this 3 here, another 1, another 1, another 1 if you distribute. So you're pretty much doing 1 times 3 to the 4th power, right? Because you have this, 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 that, 4 times. And if you look back, this is 3 to the 0th power place, 3 to the 1st place, 3 to the 2nd, 3 to the 3rd, 3 to the 4th. So it's the same thing. You pretty much just like factor out the 3s if you look at the usual expansion. But anyway, if you just work this out in the usual sense, you will get the answer in the usual sense, namely base 10. But if you do all the computation in base 7, the answer in the end will be the answer in base 7, right? So we are going to think everything in base 7 from now on. Okay, so here we go. I am going to be looking at two numbers and operation at a time, of course. So here we go. 1 times 3, this is just 3, okay? And then I will add 1. And I think this is how it should work. I'm not going to write down rest, okay? So we have 3 plus 1. And this is something we can do. So 3 plus 1 is 4. Good. And next comes the tricky part. We are going to multiply this by 3. And now, what is 4 times 3? I know you want to say 12, but 12 in base 7 is what? It's 1/5. Because 12 is the same as 7 plus 5. So it's 1/5. And this right here is why I tell you guys you should have the times table on the side in base 7. So, if you are going to do 4 times 3, you can look at 4 and 3, you see, is 1/5. So, 4 times 3 is 1/5 in base 7. And then we'll continue. We are going to add 2, and you see, 5 plus 2. I know you guys want to say 7, but in the base 7 world, you have to say 1/0. Once again, 5 plus 2 is 1/0, and plus this 1, so it's 2/0, like this. And then we pretty much continue. Next, we are going to multiply by 3, just line this up like this. And 2/0 times 3 is just 6/0, right? 3 times 0 is 0, 3 times 2 is legitimately 6. And then next, I will just add 0, so this is pretty easy, this is still 6/0. And then I will multiply by 3, 6/0 times 3. 3 times 0 is 0, and then 3 times 6 is, you can look at the times table on the side, 3 and 6 right here. When you multiply, you get 2, 4. Why? Because 3 times 6 is 18. 18 is the same as 14 plus 4. So you have to have 2 and 4 to get the 18. 2 means 2 times 7 to the first power, that's how we get the 14, and then plus that 4. So just as 3 times 6 is 2, 4, and then of course you attach a 0. And in the end, you just put down plus 1, and of course when you combine all this, 2, 4, 1. And here you have it. This number in base 7 is 2, 4, 1. And that's it. And if you guys would like to know, both of this equal to the number 127 in base 10. And now, let's see how to go from a bigger base to a smaller base, right here. And I will show you guys this one, 372 in base 9. I will change that to base 7. And when you go from a bigger base to a smaller base, you have some trouble. First of all, we still have to talk about how to expand this, but we have to do it really carefully. Because 7 is not allowed in the base 7 world. Likewise, 9 is also not allowed in the base 7 world. So when you go from a bigger base to a smaller base, this right here is a trouble already. You have to know what is 9 in the base 7, okay? So let's do it carefully. I will start from the number from the left, which is this 3 right here. And I will say multiply by, I cannot put down 9. I will have to put down 1, 2 right here. Because remember, if you want to get to base 7, you have to think everything base 7. This right here is the 9 in base 7, right? And then I will add the next number, which is this 7. But 7 in the base 7 world is what? 1, 0. So I will actually put down 1, 0 here, and then we'll put a parenthesis, and then multiply by this in base 7, which is 1, 2. And then in the end, I will add 2, like this. So this is how I'm going to look at the expansion, right? Because we are working everything base 7 now. And just like earlier, I'm just going to multiply this as how it is. Okay, 3 times 1, 2 is just 3, 6. This is okay. And then I'm going to add 1, 0 to it. And when I do that, this is just 4, 6. Okay, 0 plus 6 is 6. 1 plus 3 is 4. So far, so good. And then I will have to multiply by 1, 2 after that. And this right here is, you know, crazy. So let's do it on the side. Here we go. 2 times 6 in the base 7. I know it's 12 in the regular sense, but it's 1, 5 in base 7. And if you were like, you see, 2 times 6 is 1, 5. So what you do is you put down the 5 right here, and then you have the 1, 5 like this, right? Next, 2 times 4 is 1, 1. If you would like, 2 times 4 is 1, 1. So 1, 1 plus this 1, you get 1, 2. Okay? So this is it with the 2 right here, and now we move on to this 1. And 1 times this is just all that, which is just 4, 6 like this. Of course, you leave a blank right here. And then you are going to add them up in the base 7 sense. 5 and nothing is 5. 2 and 6 is 1, 1. So 1, 1. Okay? And then 1 plus 1 is 2 plus 4 is 6. So you have 6, 1, 5 like this. Alright, so this right here, after you multiplied it, you get 6, 1, 5. And then just one more. We are going to add 2 to it. 5 plus 2, I know it's 7, but in base 7, you have to say that's 1, 0. And then 1, 1 is just 2, and then this right here is still 6. So in the end, when you do all that, you get 6, 2, 0. So this right here, the answer to it is 6, 2, 0. And the answer to this in base 10, in the usual sense, is that we have, of course, in purple, 308. This is the value of this in the usual sense. I think it's a lot of fun. Try not to go in the same two, right? So that's it.